Okay, so staying in the School of Science, our next candidate, Michael Donohoe, the title of his work is In-Body Energy Harvesting Nanosensors for Neutral Activation.
Afternoon. Nanosensors are microscopic electronic sensors that you can distribute in the environment or in a room or even in a human body. And they are for sensing data values, data processing, or perhaps even activating some particular function. If you're powering them is a problem, though, so you could use energy from the surroundings, like whether it's heat or vibrational energy or some system like that. So we are looking specifically at if you put nanosensors, which are about 1,000 square micrometers in area, into the human body. First of all, we have to protect them with some sort of an artificial membrane that's biocompatible. But secondly, we want to power them in a safe way. So we envisage using a portable ultrasound device that emits ultrasound vibrations into the human tissue. It reaches the nanosensors, and the nanosensors have these piezoelectric nanowires, which when bent will generate small amounts of electric energy. However, if you're using ultrasound into human tissue, it does get absorbed, and it gets absorbed at different frequencies. The safe limit of ultrasound power to put into a human body is 720 millimwatts per square centimeter. And if you use higher frequencies, they will get absorbed in tissue far more than lower frequencies. This is just for one type of tissue, skin fat, the penetration of it centimeters in. You can see that the higher frequency is absorbed much more than the lower frequency. But more to the point, if you go into denser tissue then, such as muscle or bone, you get even more absorption, and you also get reflection of ultrasound, where you change from one tissue type to another, like from muscle to bone. That's the basis of ultrasound imaging. So we're looking at using the lowest possible frequency to retain as much power as possible into the tissue, which is the 50 kilohertz. We're also looking at having it only in one type of tissue, which would be skin fat. So we're looking at using our nanosensors to stimulate activity in the peripheral nervous system, the peripheral nervous of the arm, for example, the median nerve or the ulnar nerve. In the forearm or in the wrist are only a few millimeters deep. And by sending timed pulses of energy into these, we can stimulate motor neurons or sensory neurons. This is to particularly overcome perhaps cases of nerve damage. One nanosensor on its own doesn't produce enough power for that, so we're looking at combining them, coupling them together into and putting them in tissue engineered patches to put upon directly upon the nerve, or better still within the nerve, the fascicles where the neurons that you might want to stimulate are actually buried. So our modeling is dimensioning patches like this, how many nanosensors you need, how much energy you can produce, and what is the probability of stimulating the neurons that you need. So if you're ever going to hospital in the future to be patched up, maybe that's the kind of patch they'll be using for you. Thank you.
Mike, why don't you use the energy in the body itself to charge these? I mean, you have pulses going through the body that you could actually harness as an energy source.
It's a question of intensity and how much energy you actually can get even out of internally in the body, and also the kind of transducer that you use. At least the piezoelectric nanowires, we know how they move in vibration or form or that. But if you're going to use something else in the body, you're going to use a completely different system. You're going to use maybe piezoelectric crystals, but they have their own limitations as well. So specifically, because we were looking at nanowires and bending nanowires, this seemed to be a good application for those specific transducers.
So you couldn't jump up and down and charge them that way?
Oh, it would be very difficult. It might be vibrating very hard though, to do it.
And they are actuated by an external ultrasound.
Yes.
But they're still quite close to the surface.
Relatively close to the surface, but millimeters or maybe even a centimeter down. As long as it's a tissue like skin fat that doesn't absorb too much of the ultrasound, and as long as you're using a lower frequency like 50 kilohertz, okay, you will transfer sufficient energy into them to vibrate them enough okay. to get and the voltage you need.
How do you know when is enough? Or how do you measure how much is needed? Or
actually,
how do you know about ambient ultrasound from microwaves that you're picking up that are not actuating it?
Microwaves would...
Not microwaves, other ultrasound sources.
Again, it's to do with the intensity. This type of intensity we're talking about, you wouldn't get it from stray ultrasound.
Okay.
This is something specifically put into the skin for this.
Thanks, Michael.